What are we all watching this week? What kept you reaching for more or agonizing when there was no more? And what made you want to throw your remote through the screen? Time to weigh in, Dramabeans Mr. Sunshine. There's a lot going on and we're still setting the pieces in place, but everything looks cinematic and grandiose in a way we don't often get in drama land, and that's refreshing, even if I don't think it quite hits Goblin levels of emotion or scale. The time period feels like we're on the cusp of something significant, a feeling that carries over into the drama itself. I don't know yet if I like the show, but it has me interested. I can't help but wish we were centered around Yoo Yun Seok's anti-hero journey into redemption and self-acceptance, though, because I find his Dong Mei a hell of a lot more electric than boring Ol Eugene, and think his arc will be a lot more gripping. What's wrong with Secretary Kim? I feel like I'm meant to care more about the kidnapping backstory than I do, but I hope that now that the truth is out, we can move past the not-quite-mysterious foreshadowing and return to focusing on young Jun and Mieso's relationship. Kidnapping has overstayed its welcome, crashing on rom-com's couch, and rom-com would like to reclaim its home, please. Are you human too? I'm a week behind on this. Shinbo is still painfully adorable and I appreciate that our heroine is the only one who really sees him as something more than a machine or a program. You could argue that she's too far gone on the other extreme, perhaps seeing him as more human than she ought, but maybe that's not such a far-fetched concept when she's actually starting to change Shinbot's AI. I'm still not sure I'm going to be happy with the resolution for him, but in the meantime I'll enjoy his sweet, guileless personality while I can, Girl Friday Mr. Sunshine. I know they were going for a splashy, epic premiere, but I honestly didn't connect with the story at all until the second episode, when Kim Tae-ri's character came to the forefront. I get that the hero's lack of allegiance to his homeland is the whole point of his character arc. It's just so much easier to connect with a character who feels very passionately about fighting for Joseon's, especially when she's defying social norms to become an active gunslinger for the resistance. So far I'm impressed with the women in this drama and encouraged by the fact that the pretty, delicate noblewoman is in fact a hot-headed rebel in training. Yes, please. And more of Yoo Yun Seok. There is never enough Yoo Yun Seok in life, ever. What's wrong with Secretary Kim? I was bored by all of the heavy focus on the kidnapping backstory and Hyung drama this week, but hopefully that means we're past it now. We're past it, right? It's nice to finally see Park Seo-joon's side of things, and all the little ways in which he, secretly, stupidly, cared for Park Min-young over the years. Now that the dramatic stuff is over with, can we just stick to office coming out shenanigans and awkward bedroom seduction tactics? No one's pretending that's not what we signed up for. Teriyaki investigation couple. I'm happy that I stuck with this one through the major slowdown just to get to the final case. A new investigation reopens a decades-old case and the pressure is on both the prosecution and forensic teams to solve it. They have learned to work well together and this investigation should highlight that fact. This drama has been a challenge to stick with, but something about Jung Jae-young's back BEOM kept me coming back. I'm hoping that there's a possibility of real happiness waiting for the lonely medical examiner. Your house helper, this drama acknowledges how bogged down people can get when their personal spaces are cluttered. Ji-woon restores order to his clients' homes and in the process, they see their lives more clearly. He's an interesting cross between an organizational whiz and a psychologist. I'm eager to see how Da-young and her new roommates will be further influenced by Ji-woon's advice going forward because clearly their lives have stalled for one reason or another. Laeka Handsome Guy and Young EUM, this mediocre rom-com was the perfect thing to watch in the post-surgical haze after I got my wisdom teeth out this week, but I doubt it will leave any lasting impression on me, and not because I've been hopped up on painkillers. It's a shame that it's such a paint-by-numbers story, with a plot that would have worked fine in 12 hours but drags in 16. Especially so because I had such high hopes for this reunion between her Wang Young EUM and Nam Goong Min, who had their wires so heartbreakingly, beautifully crossed in Can You Hear My Heart? This cast certainly has the acting chops for a much more demanding script, but not only are the lead roles lackluster, the secondary roles are wasted on Choi Tae-joon and Oh Yoon-ah. I've put away my hopes for a cracktastic watch, and decided to simply enjoy the cuteness of the OTP, who are complete dorks in love by this point. What's